everyone, I'm back with a new video and today's topic is atomic structure. It is from the physical chemistry. First of all, let us know about what exactly is atom. It was the term given first by John Dalton. Atom, when we break atom, it is basically A and T-O-M. A in Greek means not and tom means divisible. Basically, it means in not divisible. John Dalton has given first atomic theory, and it is like he said, matter is made up of extremely small indivisible particles known as atom. But this was later proved incorrect, as atom was further made up of subatomic particles known as neutrons, protons and electrons. So his first theory was proven wrong. Second one was atoms of same element are same type but differ from atoms of other element. It basically means that same element has same kind of properties but it differs from other element. Let us take an example to get it clear. For example, hydrogen atom differs from carbon atom. Similarly, hydrogen gas differs from some other gases, but isotopes proved it wrong. Isotope of hydrogen, there are three isotopes basically. So this theory was again proved wrong. Third one given was different atoms combine in a simple ratio to form a compound. This theory of Dalton's was exactly right. For example, CO2, carbon dioxide gas, carbon, one of carbon atom and two of oxygen atom combines in a particular ratio. And we can take an example of water also, H2O. Here, two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. Atom has definite mass, but it is structureless, as said by Dalton, was again proven wrong because it has some structure. There was protons, electrons and neutrons present inside it. Now the fifth one was, atom can neither be created nor be destroyed. Now, discovery of electron was basically done by J.J. Thomson, and the name electron was given by Stoney. Electron was discovered by a cathode ray experiment. He first took a glass tumbler and a vacuum pump to control the level of gas inside it. He then took cathode and anode and connected it to a battery, from where he passed 10,000 volts of electricity to see that what happens inside it. He then covered one part of the tumbler with ZnS, zinc sulfide. Then some particles passed through it, because of which there were some bright spots being created on the zinc sulfide layer. This led to the discovery of electrons. Next comes discovery of protons, which was done by Goldstein, and it was done with the help of anode ray experiment. It was the same setup, just the cathode and anode were interchanged, because then again on zinc sulfide there were some bright spots created, because of which Goldstein was able to see that there were some positive particles and named it as protons. The gas present inside the tumbler was hydrogen gas. When 10,000 volts of electricity was passed in both the cases, hydrogen was ionized into H+ ion and then with an electron, due to which there were some bright spots created on the zinc sulfide. Now let us know about the mass of electron, proton and neutron. Mass of electron in kg is 9.1 × 10⁻³⁻³ kg, or 0.0005 amu. Mass of proton is 1672 × 10⁻²⁷ kg, or 1.0007 amu. Mass of neutron is slightly different from proton, but is almost near 1.6 0.75 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg or 1.008 ANU. Basically, if someone asks which particle is more heavier in comparison of neutron and proton, then we must say neutron is slightly heavier than proton as compared between both of them. Now, let us talk about the charge of proton, neutron and electron. Charge of proton is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Charge of neutron is minus 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. And as we all know, neutron has no charge, so its charge is zero. Next comes specific charge of electron. Specific charge is basically charge divided by the mass of the electron. We always take the specific charge in modulus, so it can never be negative. Specific charge of electron is basically minus 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb divided by 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg. When we calculate it, it comes about 1.76 into 10 to the power 11 coulomb per kg. This is very important as per the needs perspective. Proton specific charge is basically charge by mass. Charge of proton is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb and its mass is 1.672 into 10 to the power minus 27. So it comes about 9.5 into 10 to the power 7 coulomb per kg. Now specific charge of neutron will also be zero because it has no charge. And even electron is also called as cathode ray, as it was found with the help of cathode ray experiment. So if anyone asks what is the specific charge of cathode ray, then we must say it is 1.76 into 10 to the power 11 coulomb per kg. And also proton is also called anode ray. So if anyone asks specific charge of it, then we must say it is 9.5 into 10 to the power 7 coulomb per kg. Now let us know something about alpha particles. Alpha particles are basically helium ions, He2 plus ions. It has a mass of 4 AMU. AMU is basically atomic mass unit. Let us know about the representation of an element. As you can see, I have taken an example of carbon atom. It is the sixth element and it has an atomic mass of 12. So C, basically element is represented by X and mass of an atom is represented by A and number of protons is represented by Z. Atomic number Z is also equal to the number of protons. And mass number is the sum of protons and neutrons in the nucleus. That's all for today. Thank you.